unfortunately, sometime last year, the Minister of Sports, Honorable Isiama, inaugurated a new sports policy committee, of which I am the chairman.
Okay.
And the sports policy committee has been meeting and working over the period. I believe that the pandemic presents a new, you know, perspective to how we manage our sporting industry. And it is one of the issues that we have had discussions with members of the committee on how to fashion out a way to manage, you know, such pandemics when they do occur. So it presents us quite a good opportunity to tweak policy-wise what we should be able to do in pandemic situations like this. So, however, we should know that this pandemic is being managed at the highest level, led by the President of the Republic and health experts who guide him and advise him on the decisions that are taken on a day-to-day basis. And the sports industry is just a subset of the various sectors that, you know, are being managed. So discussions are ongoing. The stakeholders are making a strong case that games have resumed in other jurisdictions across the world under certain circumstances and with certain protocols. And people are proposing that these protocols should be adopted here as well. I believe that in the wisdom of the president, at the appropriate time, when a decision is taken generally on public gatherings and the way we manage, you know, some of these things, including sports, when that decision is made, we in the sector would then now finalize our discussions in terms of what type of protocols we're going to use moving forward. Because you know that sports is huge business and it's huge entertainment. A lot of life depend on the industry, and therefore, as a form of entertainment during this period, it would have been prudent for us to be able to see teams play, and as people stay home and work from home and all of that, some of these things would have been what would entertain people. However, it's not been the case. So moving forward, I believe that discussions will be ongoing, and once the health team advising the president advises that we can resume normal public life with a certain level of protocols and restrictions, then us in the various sectors will also now fashion out what we will do moving forward in managing the league, and especially looking at the fact that our league has had some ups and downs in the last couple of years. If you looked at what happened after the announced documentary, football had to go into normalization. And then during normalization, we had to play a special competition to keep football, you know, on the front burner and all of that. And then also going into an election and electing a new executive for the Ghana Football Association. And I must commend the new team for the zeal and the spirit with which they've sort of administered football in Ghana in the last few months.
You've worked well so far with them.
And we've worked well so far with them. And you saw how Ghanaians were beginning to warm up to the Bring Back the Love campaign, and how we all began to throng the stadium and, you know, football matches. And you saw that genuinely that love that Ghanaians used to have for football that had waned over the years was gradually coming back. Just the week before we recorded two cases in Ghana, the next weekend we're going to have a qualifier played here in Ghana. All of that had to be cancelled and all of that. So it tells you that football, for instance, has taken a big blow, and the pandemic has not been merciful to our football, especially at the time when we were just about picking up again. I'm hoping that with the necessary protocols that we're going to put in place, when we get back, the fans would still stay, and when we actually get to opening up the facilities for fans to go into the stadium, they'll come in their numbers, because it is definitely a cycle. The fans are important, the teams are important, and it is you know, the coming together of the two that makes the games, great.
We know.